Bob Blackman.
Thank you very much, Mr. Deputy Speaker, and a pleasure to follow my honourable friend, the Member for Henley. Our thoughts at this time must be, of course, with the Queen and with the Royal Family who've lost a loved one. But, of course, we are now celebrating a long and distinguished life, whether it is in military history, whether it's in his efforts to encourage people to become environmentalists, his protection of the wildlife, but in particular, in my view, his love of science and technology, which I think in his earlier years came very much to the fore. Now, I express my appreciation for the visits that the Queen and Prince Philip made to the London Borough of Harrow, the most recent being, of course, during the Queen's 2012 Jubilee, when they visited Krishna Avanti School as being their visit to the London Borough of Harrow. Krishna Avanti, of course, is the first state-sponsored Hindu primary school in the country. And he met the various different children from various different backgrounds and had various different performances, demonstrating the multicultural nature of Harrow. But he also was present for the 150th anniversary of the Harrow Zoroastrian community. And that demonstrates his willingness to reach out to religions right across the world and bring people together. And I think that's the thing that, of course, brings us back to celebrate his life. He also visited, way back in 1959, Harrow Boys Club to celebrate their centenary. And the reality was that his efforts to encourage young people to participate in youth clubs and beneficial activities, of course, we celebrate the Duke of Edinburgh Awards. They started in a very small way and, of course, have now burgeoned into one of the activities that is encouraged across schools and beyond. I remember my visits to Buckingham Palace to meet the Queen and Prince Philip, the garden parties, and my most vivid memory was that of visiting Windsor Castle as a Queen Scout to be awarded the Badge of Honour when I was a very young man. We will remember him for his wonderful life and devoted service. I hope that in due course we'll have a suitable memorial in the Palace of Westminster to his great long life, and there could be no greater memorial than actually having another royal yacht entitled Prince Philip. Thank you, Mr. Deputy Speaker, for allowing me to pay tribute to a wonderful man who will be sadly missed.